Hello guys, welcome to this tutorial, and in this tutorial we are going to be talking about prop drilling. So what exactly is prop drilling in React? Okay, wait, this is what it means. Prop drilling is a situation whereby a parent component generates its own state and it now passes the state down as props to its children component or one of its children components. And the component that it passes the prop down to does not use the prop, does not consume the prop. Instead, it also passes it down to another component which finally uses it. And in some cases, that one can also pass it down to another component to use it. And once we have that, we have what is called prop drilling in React. Okay, wait, this is what I mean. Look at this app component you can see on the screen. It has a state, right? And we assign it to a variable called profile. We don't even use profile in the app component, but what do we do instead? We pass it down to a component, a child component of the app component, right? Which is called header component, right? So we pass the profile to the header component. The thing we want to look out for is whether the header component that we passed down the prop to, we use it or not. So if it uses it, then we don't have to worry about prop drilling. But if it does not use it, instead, it passes it down to another component. So in that case, we have prop drilling. Let's check out the content of the header component to see whether it makes use of the prop passed down to it, or it also passes it down to another component. Now let's check it out. Boom! Can you see that? You can see that in the header component we have content component, and the content component is the one that receives the prop that is passed down to the header component. The header component does not use the prop passed down to it, but it only passes it down to another component. What is happening? Oh, we have what is called prop drilling whenever you see that. So now if we check the content component, we'll realize that it will be consumed in the content component. Let's check it out and see what happened. Boom. Can you see that? It is used. Yes, it is used here. Yeah? So if this happens, we have what is called prop drilling. And in some cases, the content component you are seeing here may not also consume it. It can also pass it down to another component, right? That one may not also use it. It can also pass it down to another component. Like, wait, before we continue, subscribe to this channel now so that when we get another tutorial, you have access to them without wasting time. So now let's continue. Now drilling a hole, right? That is what is called prop drilling. But most of the time, the hardest part of prop drilling is not actually knowing this is prop drilling, is that you don't even know when you are writing your code until later you realize you have a lot of prop drilling issue in your code. So how do you figure it out intuitively without thinking about it? And that is exactly what I want to tell you right here. So if you want that to happen, there is something you have to know, and I called it elongated props. Elongated props, they makes it visible anytime you are having prop drilling or you are writing React code that has prop drilling. Automatically you see it, you realize it, and you cut it short like that. That is how it happens. So let me explain what elongated props are. Elongated props is that prop you pass down, right? For example, you know, I showed you the app component before, right? Let me explain it again so that you get what elongated props are. Look at this app component, right? It has a state, right? We have profile here. We pass it down to header component, right? When we check out the header component here, can you see it here? You realize it does not use the prop. Instead, it passed down the same prop that it received from its parent to another component, which is content in this case. The prop that is being passed in this case is called what? Elongated props. The props that we are passing in this case is called what? elongated probe. Anytime you see that, you know automatically you have probe drilling in your component, in your react component, automatically once you see that. So how do you realize it without stress? Is that whenever you see a component that has no state, but it receives a probe from its parent, instead of using the probes, it passes down the same probe down to another component. So the probes that are being passed in this case are known as elongated probe. And anytime you see that in your code base, you know that you are using probe drilling in your code. Oh, wait, are you thinking what I am thinking? What exactly is wrong with probe drilling? Because we always pass probes down, right? When you now pass probes, you don't use, right? In some component on the last one that makes use of it. Then what is wrong with that? The thing is, when you don't have a lot of components, you will not have any issue with probe drilling. But later, when you have thousands of components, a lot of components, and you want to refactor your code, you now realize that, wow, how does this one list to this one? How does this one connect to that one? Because you don't see the connection. You don't see the flow. You don't see what is being consumed. So it is hard to actually figure it out. So you can be making some unnecessary mistake at scale. You only have to worry about probe drilling at scale. There is no much problem about it when you don't have a lot of components. That is it. Now, another thing you have to ask yourself is, how do you fix probe drilling in React? There are three major ways to fix this, and the common ones, we call them component composition, right? So how do you fix probe drilling with component composition? If you want to fix probe drilling with component composition, you need to first understand what is called context, component context. A component context is anything that is visible or runs within that component. Wait, this is it. Look at this app component. Whatever you can see in this component is within the context of this app component. So anytime you want to pass props down to grandchildren, right? Normally it is straightforward to pass a prop to children, right? But grandchildren, right? So if you want to pass props to grandchildren, especially when their parents do not use the prop, the best thing you can do in this case is to compose the children. Now, this is how to go about it. You can see in this component, we have header component in this app component. Instead of just passing props to this header component, we can bring the content component and put it inside here. Can you see that? We pass the content component as a child of the header component, and it has access automatically to the data inside of the app component. So we don't have to send it down through its parent anymore. Boom! Hooray! We have fixed that. If you look at the code we have right here, we have lifted up the content component, and it has access to the data from app directly. We don't need to pass it through the parent component anymore. What I am saying now is, anytime you want to pass data to the grandchildren, especially when the parents do not use the props, the best thing you can do is to bring the grandchildren and place them as the children of the parent. Like in this case, you can see we now have content within the header component, and the header does not need to take the props again. So all we just have to do now is to pass this as children to the header component. We have to change the header component and add children to it so that it will receive the content component as a child. By doing this, you fix probe drilling straight away. But there is a problem. If you look at this, we have a redundant component. That is an issue because you have a lot of redundant components. The header component does virtually nothing. That is how we accumulate a lot of components that we don't need. There is another way to solve it, and I call it children replacing parent strategy. How do you go about this? Anytime a parent component takes props and it does not use it, but instead it passes it down to its children, another component, in that case we use the children of that parent component to replace it in its position within its spirit. We are going to replace it. This is how to go about it. Look at this app component. We have header component, right? And header component contains content component. The header component does nothing. Instead of leaving the header component there and having an unnecessary component, a redundant component, we can lift the content of the header component and put it in the position of header in the app component. That means we replace the header component with its content. So that is what is called children replacing parent strategies. We replace the header component with its content, and in that case we remove unnecessary components, and at the same time we fix prop drilling. That is another great way of fixing prop drilling in React. Another way to fix prop drilling is to use state moving to consumer strategy. The problem of these strategies is similar to the problem of component composition, because in some cases we have redundant components. For example, in this app component now, we don't need the state, right? Instead of putting the state here where we don't need it, we can lift it and just put it where we consume it. So we just take it and put it down here in the content component that actually makes use of it. So we avoid our prop drilling like that. Can you see that? We have avoided prop drilling. By that, we have avoided prop drilling. But the problem is that there are times that the app component may have many children, and one of the children actually use the data. Or there are some cases where app uses the data itself. So in that case, you cannot lift the state. The only thing you can do is to copy it and put it in content component. And that's another problem. So you create another problem like that. The best way to actually fix this is to use children replacing parent strategy. If a component is passing down data it does not generate, it does not use, then that component is redundant. You can use its content to replace it in its parent. So you can actually do that. So, and that will remove prop drilling, and at the same time it will remove redundant components if you use that. If you think about it, what exactly is the cause of prop drilling? Majorly, the cause of prop drilling is the fact that a component that does not need data takes it, and instead of using it, it passes it down to another component. So if that happens, you don't need that component. Just copy its content and use it to replace it in its parent. That's all. Another cause is that a component that should be self-contained, that should have its own state, we don't give it its own state. We just force it to receive props from its parents. And by doing that, we automatically cause prop drilling. There are some components that represent the section of a page or a website, you know. In those cases, they are always self-contained. And once they are self-contained, they should have their own data instead of connecting them or forcing them to receive data from a parent component. And once we do that, automatically we are causing something called prop drilling. And the best way to fix that is that anytime you see a component, right, taking prop and does not use the prop but only passes it down to another component, that is prop drilling. So don't even think about it. That is prop drilling, tested and trusted. So the best way is just take the content of that component and use it to replace itself in its parent. Let me show you once again so that you get everything. Instead of passing content, the content component, as a child to other components, we can just take the content of the header component, delete that header component, and put the content inside of the app component, and everything will be fixed. No prop drilling already, because everything, they have access directly to the source of data. They have access directly to the source of data. By doing that, automatically you fix prop drilling, and that is the best way to fix prop drilling as far as far as I'm concerned. So see you another time. Bye for